Inner Traditions Audio presents The Chiron Effect, Healing Our Core Wounds Through Astrology, Empathy, and Self-Forgiveness by Lisa Tahir, LCSW. Read by the author. This work is dedicated to those of you who are learning the value of being happy over being right, who view your missteps and challenges as opportunities to become a more evolved and happier version of yourself, to you who are consciousness shifters, and to you who have journeyed to the inner depths of life, love, and loss, yet have chosen to rise from the dark nights of your soul with a beautifully scarred yet open heart, a heart filled with the desire to forgive yourself and others so that you may love and be loved more deeply. I am grateful to each of you who have come to me disguised as my client, family member, friend, lover, or stranger in the street, only to remind me of the reality that we are all connected, united by our humanity. You have shined a light upon my path, which has illuminated my heart with greater humility, peace, happiness, and the wisdom to choose only love. My intention is to be a vessel for Spirit's messages and a light of guidance in this world so that I may add to the eternally growing narrative and conversation about emotional healing and spiritual development. May we each linger longer and listen to our inner voice, encouraging us to deeper awareness. Whatever you have been through, don't silence yourself. Take risks to be authentic, for there you will find your courage. To quote His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama, "The planet does not need more successful people. The planet desperately needs more peacemakers, healers, restorers, storytellers, and lovers of all kinds." End quote. And so it is, and so it shall be, in all directions and in every dimension. Amen. Acknowledgements. Mom and Dad, you have taught me my most valuable life lessons about forgiveness and happiness. Thank you for co-creating my foundation in unconditional love. I am the oldest of 5 unique siblings, all of whom I love deeply. I appreciate you, Ashley, my dear sister, for being the rock I can depend upon. Ruby, you are actually a step-in mother who has enlivened my family with your humor and spirit. We are a dynamically blended Pakistani-American family, and my favorite memories are with all of you in my New Orleans home laughing hysterically about anything. I am also blessed by the presence of a second family and mentorship found in Jean and Mary Koss. Thank you, Jean, for gifting me with glass art as a way of healing through creating and by believing in me. Since I was a child, I have wanted to work in the field of psychology. I've gone through many iterations of myself since my parents found a note I had scribbled when I was 5. It read, "I want to be a psychiatrist." As it turned out, the challenges and gifts of being a healer have been the driving force in creating my life. There is a sacred intimacy to the therapeutic relationship. With each step I take toward answering my call to be of service, I've grown into a woman of deeper integrity. Thank you to each and every client for choosing me to walk with you through the deep valleys of your soul. My heart has been with you each step and will be forevermore. I have cultivated a circle of spiritual mothers who have supported me as both mentors and sisters. They are Aura Nadrich, Catherine Woodward Thomas, Marianne Williamson, Prim Glidden, and Deborah Volker. As strong, authentic women, your power comes from the spiritual truths you each embody and live by. As a result, I have been blessed by the generosity of your wisdom. Thank you. I have found a spiritual home as a member of the Self-Realization Fellowship in Pacific Palisades, California, which was founded by Paramahansa Yogananda in 1950. I have spent the last few years taking walks on its beautiful grounds that surround Lake Shrine and meditating in its windmill chapel. Miraculous changes have transpired in my life as a result. Dedicated to the upliftment of humanity through prayer is a tenet taught by Yogananda that I believe in and live by. I have directed healing energy to others, including those of you hearing this book. I am grateful to be a part of this spiritual community and want to acknowledge the power and alignment I have found through my devotion. Thank you, Gary Reggio and Robert Neelig, my web designers and trusted collaborators. I appreciate your innovation, focused creativity, and support for my work over the years. Peter Hoff, thank you for your knowledge and expertise in helping me with this book. You and your wife, Claire Candy Hoff, are wonderful friends and inspirational creators who enrich my life. Mari Selby, your wisdom as my editor, contributor, and collaborator to this book have been invaluable. Jeanette Inglis, thank you for your prodigious and meticulous attention to detail in the editing of my book and the clarity you brought to it. Thank you, Margie Baxley, for adding touches and details to this manuscript. Gratitude to you, Robert Weinberg Esquire, for your legal guidance and intellectual banter. I'd like to thank you, Matteo Nievert, for being an inspiration to me through this writing process, through our artistic collaborations throughout the years. My publisher, Inner Traditions, has brought this work out into the world. I am grateful for your co-creation with me in reaching people with Chiron's message of forgiveness and self-healing. I thank you, John Graham, for discovering and selecting my book for publication, and Kelly Bowen for a positive contract negotiation experience. Megan McLean, you have made editing fun, dare I say, through your supportive style and guidance. Thank you, Manzanita Carpenter-Sons, for scheduling upcoming and ongoing events that connect readers with this information. The support you have each given me in bringing this work to the mainstream for people everywhere to access is cherished. And Randy Pizer, your commitment, expertise, and direction as my agent has brought this book into the hands of so many, and I am grateful for you and your efforts. Introduction. Chiron and psychoastrology. A school shooting, a drunk driver taking an innocent life, the loss of a job, a loved one, or a relationship. Now more than ever, people turn to therapists, spiritual healers, and countless other professionals for support and healing. Yet those of us who work to relieve the emotional pain of humanity have shortcomings of our own, even as we serve our highest calling. Chiron was discovered in 1977 by American astronomer Charles T. Cowell from images taken at Palomar Observatory in San Diego, California. Chiron has the unusual characteristic of features like both an asteroid and a comet. It was recognized as the first object in the Centaur class. Centaurs are objects with unstable orbits, and Chiron remains one of the largest such worlds known. It was initially classified as an asteroid and as a minor planet, 2060 Chiron. Today, it is classified as both a minor planet and a comet, and is known by the cometary designation 95P Chiron. This work that you are now hearing accurately identifies 12 areas of core wounding diagnosed by the astrological placement of Chiron in the listener's birth chart. It is this placement.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.